Yeah, JJ really did a great job leading the team this past weekend. An overall win at the college level, especially with the many D1 teams that were there. It's very special, and very happy for JJ. And again, the fact that he was followed closely by Brady Homer, and then we had a few guys, Isaac Haas, Fred Fortuna, Zach Holtkamp, all came together real nicely there for our top five. Did a great job to win the Queen City Invitational. It's certainly a feather in our cap, and it's something we've never done before. We've competed at that meet almost every year that I've been a coach, which is 20 years, and then some years before that. So 32nd running, we'll take the victory. It's probably been 30 years coming. Absolutely, and it's the fresh blood of our freshmen. Kelly Burrows and McKenzie McDaniel have really made a difference up front. They've gone out. They're pushing it in practice. They're pushing it in the meets, and our upperclassmen are actually enjoying that. Kelly Johnson has responded wonderfully in answering the call up front. The two freshmen and Kelly that I just mentioned went 1-2-3 for us within 2 seconds, and when you've got three runners crossing the line like that in a pack, it really helps the team score. So we're trying to get our fourth and fifth runner up there a little bit further, and the single digits as far as low scores for the meet will hopefully continue. The expectations, we haven't been down Vanderbilt for, it's been 12 years since we last raced there, and we did all right last time we were there. It's a challenging course. It's the same course that our conference meet will be on in November, so we're seeing a few conference teams there. East Tennessee State on the men's side are ranked number one in our conference, so we'll get a good chance at them and a shot to see how we stack up. I believe certainly Lipscomb will be there. Former A-Sun team Belmont, which is always good on men's and women's side, will be there. Mercer's going to be there. I don't know if Kennesaw is going to be there or not, but we'll have a host of teams from Tennessee and Kentucky. Moorhead will be there. Western Kentucky will be there. And like I said, about 15 Tennessee teams will be there. It'll be a very challenging event. I think they've got about 30 teams registered total, and we're looking forward to running in Nashville.